Good evening, everyone. I'm Nitya Girish from second year mechanical engineering, and I would like to speak a few words for the motion, online education does more harm than good. Education is not just about textbook learning and writing tests and scoring grades. It's more of a wholesome and enlightening experience, especially for young children, because they get to meet their peers and get out of their comfort zones and interact with the outside world and explore, you know, the outside world. So I feel the biggest disadvantage of online education is social isolation and the lack of human interaction. So like this leads to a lot of mental health issues like anxiety and stress and a lot of negative thoughts. In a traditional classroom environment, teachers can give face-to-face feedback to their students, and this makes the learning experience for students easier. Whereas in online classrooms, it is not that effective. Also, when there's face-to-face communication and activities with the faculties and peers, students tend to stay more motivated and they push themselves more to achieve their goals or complete their tasks. But I feel in online education, in online classrooms, students are left to motivate themselves, and not every student will be in the mental state to, you know, have that kind of perseverance or just, you know, have good time management skills. Moreover, how much ever teachers try, cheating and malpractices cannot be completely avoided in online assessments. And students knowing all that, I feel they don't put in enough effort. They just take assessments very lightly. The courses which require practical experiences, practical knowledge, such as medical sciences and engineering for us, they're not able to provide that to their students. And education becomes just mostly theoretical, and there's very less practical exposure. And we all know that communication skills and soft skills are very essential, like when we in our professional lives, you know, to thrive in our professional lives. And online education kind of inhibits the development of those skills in students. We've also been hearing all these incidents where school students are committing suicide because of a lack of access to internet and technology, because of their financial constraints or many other reasons. So while online education might be convenient to some people, for some people, that is not the case for everybody. Like, that's not the case for, you know, in general. So like if traditional education was almost, it was equally available for all students.
3 minutes.
Okay. It was equally available for all students. Online education must also be in the same manner. So till all educational institutions are able to provide good quality online education to their students, I feel online education just does more harm than good.
Good afternoon, sir and ma'am. I'm Jagisani Tripathi from third year EEE department. So today I'll be speaking against the motion like online education does more harm than good. So I'll be speaking against it. Like in today's world, almost everything is going to be digital. So in this at this point of time, when a pandemic strikes, we can't think of also offline classes. Even if we require sometimes labs and all, only for those people who require labs and PhD scholars who are doing their research, we can go for offline. But for others, when we can go for online classes, we don't require offline classes. Like I'll be saying the merits and advantages of this. We can read it at our own space, like as per our wish and as per our space and speed. Like for understanding also, we will be going as per our speed so that it helps us for better understanding. And it also has got much more flexibility than the offline classes. In online classes, we can think of, doing various projects and internships, so which will be helping us for our placements as well. And those who are preparing for GATE also, they'll be getting much more time for reading their other things. So if we are going for online classes, then we'll be having much more technical skills also, like we'll be using Slack and Rainbow Zoom and all those things, so which will be a benefit for us while doing placement. So the people searching for good employees will be, this will be an added skill for them, those who have attended online classes. And also we know that in many institutes the quality of education is not up to the mark. So at that point of time when we have got this Udemy, Coursera and all those things, we can definitely upgrade ourselves. We can upgrade ourselves for better things. And then as my friend said, Aviram said that this will be affecting our mental health. I don't think it really affects our mental health if we go for online classes. Like we will be staying with our parents and this is definitely going to help us. If we want to engage in some physical activities, then we can definitely go, like there are badminton courts or whatever you play. You can go to that place and engage yourself physically also. So it doesn't have to be, basically what I want to say is if we want to involve ourselves in many activities, then offline class is not the only mode which we require to get ourselves involved. Thank you.
So I'm here, Rohit, to speak for the motion, online courses does more harm than good. I basically want to focus on two basic aspects. The first thing, like I am actually thinking about the plight of the students who had to join kindergarten this year. Leaving us alone, we have been discussing about our issues till now. Just think of the students who had to join kindergarten. We actually remember our experience, you know, crying and going to the school for the first time. That was our first off-home experience. And that, I believe, was the first step towards socializing towards the outside world, socializing with the unknown people. So that opportunity has it was lost as far as the present kindergarten students are concerned. And we actually go on saying the same statement again and again, like the present generation, the present students are the future of the nation. So I can't just imagine the plight of the nation after 20 to 25 years if people are actually continuing with online education, just sitting in the comforts of their homes and not socializing with all the others. And I have come across so many weird statements on social media stating that if you want to socialize among yourselves, just be active on social media. That is not the case. Just because of the fact that the comments that occur on social media are just the comments that occur from under your blanket, from under your home. That is not the real world scenario. That is not the real world experience that you're going to, you know, face in the outside world. Another aspect that I would like to mention is, like, we are actually thinking about the student's point of view. Let's think from the teacher's point of view. As far as the online education is concerned, since March, I feel that there has been a massive deterioration in the guru-shishya bond. As far as the teachers are concerned, I'm actually sharing the sorrow of all those teachers who are to retire this year. Just think of their situation. They have been there since the last 30 to 33 years working with the students. And they have actually been gaining so much from that experience. As far as a teacher is concerned, as far as a teacher's life is concerned, students is their life. Their activity is their life. And I actually can experience that from my home just because of the fact that my father is a professor. He actually teaches just as if he is talking to a wall. And without that interaction, without that human interaction, without that body language, understanding the body language of students, it seems like deadlock. So coming back to that point, people who have to retire in this March, they were actually thinking, they were actually making up their mind, stating that this is the last year in my career, so I should extract the maximum from my students. But just like a blow in their head, this thing came up and we had to shift to online education. So here what I am trying to state is that if online education is the solution for the present time being, it's well and good, but in the long run, it is not going to be a solution.
Good evening, respected judges and my worthy opponents. I, Anisha Ali from third year CSC, will be speaking against the motion. Like, our topic of the debate is online education does more harm than good. Like, it is said that change the way you look at things and the things you look at change. Currently, our education system is undergoing a huge paradigm shift. But let's look at the positive aspect of this. Like, online education has created a virtual platform where people from different origins can come and share their views. Interaction increases in online education because people can interact with each other from across the world or anywhere. If we look up to the recent studies, education has become more costlier. It is like a luxury than necessity. Like nowadays, educational institutes charge lakhs of rupees and parents pay because it's like we have to pay it to reach to that certain level. So it doesn't matter if like a child is interested or not. As said by like Anisha or someone against the motion, like it doesn't matter if the child is learning or not, but it is like compulsion when you have to go to school, attend the lectures, or you have to get a certain marks to pass it. Whereas in online education, students can choose, or it provides more flexibility. And there are some platforms like edX, Coursera, NPTEL that provides top lectures, and some are even free. Like this can increase more learning than the physical presence. And let's come to mental health, which is more important. Like students suffer, like there is a lot of tension going on. Online education is boon for those students. Like if they may be a financial, some people cannot pay a huge amount of fees charged because some have lost their jobs or are suffering from pay cuts. People suffering from mental issues, like carrying out day-to-day tasks, like getting up, going to school, which will make them tedious. It's easy to feel invisible. For students who suffer from anxiety, this feeling has magnified even more. So online education gives them time to focus on themselves rather than like trying to fit into, like they have to go to school and all those. And it's pandemic situation, then we have to be a cost efficient. As said, because people are losing their jobs and all those. So like in e-learning, materials can be quickly updated. Teachers can quickly share the information at that particular time instead of waiting for the previous or the next day, like they have to prepare themselves or to present. In online education, it saves us time, and the teachers' professional life and work life is also managed a lot because teachers don't have to spend a lot of time in school. Even if they are free, like they can just spend their time with family. So it's created a harmony between them. And as Naima mentioned about flexibility, yeah, that is true. But it also provides a stress-free environment for the students. That is the main point. Like online education does not focus on our memorization capability, which is a great factor. Like it also, like we can implement our knowledge instead of memorizing it. Like our normal education focuses on memorization. Like we have to know the certain definition to get the pass mark or something like that. So like I come to this, pandemic is disrupted almost every sector in our